Hello my dear friend, welcome to my YouTube channel. And today we are going to discuss counting Valley's Hagerank problem. So in this problem, Gary is an avid hiker. He tracks his hikes meticulously and paying close attention to small details like topography. During his last hike, he took exactly n steps. For every step he took, he noted if it was an uphill U or a downhill D steps. Gary's hike starts and ends at sea level, and each step up or down represents a 1 unit change in the altitude. So we define the following terms. A mountain is a sequence of consecutive steps above sea level, starting with a step up from sea level and ending with a step down to a sea level. A valley is a sequence of consecutive steps below sea level, starting with a step down from sea level and ending with a step up to a sea level. So given a Gary sequence of up and down steps during his last hike, we have to find and print the number of valleys he walked through. For example, if Gary's path S, which is a string, contains only two letters D and U, where D, as we know, stands for downhill and U stands for uphill, and each and every character represents a change in a altitude. D is a 1 unit change in downwards, right, and U is a 1 unit change in upwards, right. He first enters a valley 2 unit deep. You can see 2D over here, so it means it's 2 unit downward movement, so deep. Then he climbs out and up onto a mountain 2 units high, so you can see it's 2 unit deeper. Then again 2 unit up, it means now Gary is on sea level. Then again 2 unit upward, which is a 2 unit high. So finally he returns to a sea level and ends his hike. So this is the input, guys. First line contains an integer n, the number of steps in the Gary's hike, and the second line contains the string s of n characters that describe his path. Let's see the sample example here. So this is the n, which is 8. It means the number of characters present in this path is 8, and these are the 8 characters, which contains only 2 letters D and U. So guys, here you can see in explanation, underscore represents sea level and forward slash represents upward movement, and the step down is represented by a backward slash. So by using these 3 symbols, we can draw this diagram. Let's see how. So first U here, so you can see this is a sea level. First U, it means there is an upward trend, so we have to change the altitude in positive direction and go upward, so this is a 1 unit upward movement. Then we have 3D here, you can see 3D, so it means there is a change or downward trend, so we have to go 3 unit down wherever the Gary right now. From there we have to go 3 unit down, so you can see 1 unit, 2 unit, 3 unit. Then again we have a U, so it's a 1 unit upward movement. Then D, again 1 unit downward movement. And then we have 2U, means 2 unit upward, so this is a 1 unit, this is a 2nd unit. And finally Gary comes to the sea level. So you can see, so the movement is this. And now we have to find out how many valleys he has completed. Based on the definition, a valley is a sequence of consecutive steps below the sea level, starting with a step down from a sea level and ending with a step up to a sea level. So you can see, guys, so we don't have to look for the upper portion. So valley is basically this. So this is a valley. So here, how many valleys are there? Only 1. So that is why the output here is 1. So we have to find out how many valleys are there in this path. Let's try to understand the logic behind this problem, guys. So guys, we have taken an example, and this is a string, guys, which contains D and U. Most of the time I used to take a hacker example example, but this time we are taking something different because the hacker example example is too much easy and you will not be able to visualize what is happening behind it. So let's start, guys. So this is a string which contains D and U. Here D stands, you know, that is the downward movement, and U stands for upward movement. So D is represented by backward slash and U represented by a forward slash. So let me just put all those characters here. So you can see I have just mentioned how each and every character is going to represent in a diagram. So you can see it's a downward train, so it should be like this, backward slash. It's a upward train, should be like forward slash. So you can see, guys, if the downward change, then it will go minus 1 from sea level 0 to minus 1. Then it's a upward train, then we are doing plus 1 here, so it's 0. Then again it's a downward train, so again it's minus 1. Then we have again encountered a downward train, then again it's minus 2. If this is upward, then we are going 1 unit up. So like that we have noted down the change in altitude. Let's draw this string. So you can see, guys, you can say sea level, and this is the uptrend, and this is the downtrend. Basically this is a change in altitude. So this is a change in altitude. Whenever we go, based on that we'll draw this. So from this string I'll just draw the Gary's path. Let's see how. See, first is a D, so Gary will go in downward movement from zero or sea level, go very deep. Then one U here, so Gary will go up 1 unit up. Then again we have two D here, so Gary will go 2 unit down. Did you guys notice, guys, it's minus 2, right? So here also you can see it's a minus 2. So now we have 4 U's, it means Gary will go 4 unit upward. Now it reaches to 2, you can see. So here it's 2. Now again 3D here, it means 3 unit downward. 1, 2, 3. So it reaches to minus 1. So it's minus 1. So now our task is to represent how many valleys he crossed through. So you can see, guys, this is a one valley, and this is another valley. So we found two valleys in his path. So this is not a valley, guys, because it's not complete as based on the valley's definition. Whenever Gary goes below the sea level and come up or touches the sea level, it completes one valley. So what is the main crucial point which we need to think? Whenever there is a upward movement and Gary touches the sea level, we don't have to focus on this, guys, because this is a mountain part. We have seen two different things in a question. There is a mountain if it's above sea level, and there is a valley which is below sea level. So we are going to focus on this area only, below half portion. So whenever Gary goes down and goes up to the touches the sea level, it's a one valley. So our main focus should be whenever Gary touches the sea level and coming from the down. So it means whenever there is an uptrend and it's reaching, Gary is reaching to the sea level, it completes the valley. I hope you are getting this point, guys, right? So whenever we encountered U, because U stands for uptrend, and after getting the U, definitely we are going to increment 1 unit, because U stands for upward movement. So after that increment in the change in altitude in 1 unit, if Gary reaches to a sea level, it means we encountered a valley. Let's see here, guys. First was a downward trend, so it's a minus one. So we encountered U. So whenever we encountered U, we have to just check after getting the U, are we touching the sea level or not? Because if it's U, it means there's a 1 unit increment in the altitude. So previously altitude was minus one. Now there's a 1 unit increment, which would be zero. So whenever it's zero, zero is what? This is the sea level. So whenever we are going in upward movement and touching the sea level, it means we have just finished the valley. So again, if you can see, whenever we encountered a U, and after changing the altitude, if it's zero, so here you can see it's a minus one. So this is not a valley, but here we got zero. It means we have just completed. And whenever we are getting upward movement, and when it touches, or you can say the altitude is changed to zero, means we are touching the sea level from the downside. So it means this is a one valley. So here also, guys, you can see we are touching the sea level. So this is a one valley. So in the whole string, we have, or we found only two valleys. So this is the point, guys. Here we have to focus on two things. First, we don't have to think about downward movement at all, because we are mostly bothered about the valley part. There are two part which is already discussed in a Hackerang's problem. That one which is above the sea level is called mountain one, and one below the sea level which is called valley. So we have to focus on valley here, and valley also we have to make sure whenever we are going upward and we are touching the sea level, then only it will be considered as a valley, because here we are going down below the sea level, but we are not again touching the sea level. So this is not considered as a valid valley. I hope, guys, now this problem is clear to you what we have to do. So we have to focus on whenever there is a U in the string, we have to just check after getting the U or changing in the altitude whether it's zero or not. If it's zero, it means we are just finished one valley. Let me just write some condition here which will help you while you will code. So if character, suppose you got one character, because here we have D and U, you have to focus on if character is U. Why? Because we are not interested in D now. So there are two things, guys. Either it will be U or either it will be a D. So if character is U, the statement will execute, otherwise this will execute. So whenever we find U, as we know, so there's a 1 unit change or plus plus, and whenever we get D, so altitude will change towards like this. So after changing the altitude, we have to just focus on if altitude is become zero or it's touching the sea level, it means we just finished one valley, so we will increment the valley count. Suppose VC is a valley count, so we'll just increment this valley count and we'll return. Let's see the algorithm in action, guys. So this is the function, guys, counting valleys, and we are accepting two parameters as mentioned in the Hackerang platform. First is the n, which denotes the number of characters present in the string, and second is s, which is the string itself. So I've taken a two variable here, valley counter, which is initially zero, and this is the altitude, which is zero, because Gary starts his journey from sea level. So at that time, altitude will be zero. So this is a for loop, guys. So I am just looping through the each and every character of this string. So I am just extracting the character one by one here. And like what we discussed just now, here is a condition. If character is equals to U, because if it's not U, it will definitely be D, which will fall under else category. So if characters is U, I am going to just increment the altitude in a positive direction, or if character is a D, I am just going to decrement the altitude in a negative direction, or basically we are just decrementing the altitude. So after incrementing the altitude, we have to just check if Gary is reaching to the sea level or not. If it's reaching to the sea level, it means he just finishes the one valley and we have to increment the valley counter, because we just now found a valley in his path, and finally we are going to return valley counter. So the valley counter will hold how many valleys he has completed. So guys, this code is very simple and precise. I hope you love this. So let's try to run this problem in a HackerRank platform. I just copied. So I'm just pasting the solution here, guys. Sample test case got passed. Congratulations, guys. Your all test case got passed. I hope this problem is clear to you. If you want the source code of this problem, you can just download the same from my repository, and the link is mentioned in the description box. Thanks for watching, guys.